The next experiment is binary phase shift keying or BPSK modulation. We are going to look at the modulation circuit. Electronic communication can be broadly divided into analog and digital. Within analog, we have amplitude modulation AM, frequency modulation FM, phase modulation PM. Here, in analog modulation, the message signal is analog and the carrier signal is also analog. In digital communication, we are having analog shift keying ASK, frequency shift keying FSK, and phase shift keying PSK, which is also BPSK, binary phase shift keying. In digital modulation, the carrier is the same analog wave that we are using in the analog communication, but the message signal here are the streams of bits, ones and zeros, which are represented by a square waveform. As we can see here, the information bit 100101, when it is being fed into the modulator, the output of the modulator, which is the BPSK signal, consists of a waveform which is, let's say, having a phase of 0. Then when bit 0 is arriving, or when bit 0 is there, the same waveform is 180 degree phase shifted or flipped in amplitude, and we get the BPSK signal, which is composed of a series of 0 phase shifted waves or a 180 degree phase shifted wave based on the values of 1s and 0s. The basic circuit can be understood by this diagram. Here the carrier wave, which is 1 kHz, is having a higher frequency when compared to the data bits, which let us suppose comes at 100 Hz. The carrier wave is as such passed through switch S1, whereas the carrier wave, when it is passed through an inverting amplifier, which has an amplification of minus 1, has the same amplitude, but it is flipped or it's having a 180 degree phase shift. As you can see here, the waveform before the inverting amplifier and the waveform after the inverting amplifier both have a phase difference of 180 degree. So the normal wave passes through switch S1 and the inverted wave passes through S2. As we can see here, when a high is given at switch S1, it will close. At that instant, through this NOT gate, a low is given at switch S2, because of which it is not closed, it is open. So at a time, based on the values of this data bit, either this waveform or its inverted waveform will be transmitted, and at the output we get a BPSK signal. The same circuit can be made using CD4016, a NOT gate, as well as an inverting amplifier with the help of a 741 IC. So as we can see here, the carrier wave is passed through switch A by giving it at pin number 1, and the same carrier wave is inverted with the help of 741 IC, which has an amplification of minus 1 because it's an inverting amplifier configuration and both the resistance are same, so it has an amplification of minus 1. So the signal that is given at pin number 4, which is for switch B, is inverted as compared to pin number 1. The two switches SWA and SWB are controlled by pin number 5 and 13, which are controlled by the data bit stream, which is given at pin number 5, and the inverted one is given at pin number 13. So at a time, one of the switches will only work. Both the outputs are obtained at pin number 2 and 3, and they are both combined together, and we get the output, which is the BPSK output across this 10 kilo ohm resistor. Thank you.